Hello, I'm Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports, reporting for the SA Football Magazine. Today I'm joined by Division 3 Golden Grove President Ian Graham, and he's our feature president of the week. So Ian, I did notice you have a little bit of an accent.
Just a little one.
Yeah, tell us about how you got into footy, obviously coming from a different country. And yeah.
I came across to Australia in 1990, so 25 years ago, with my family. Just had one child at the time. He wasn't a footballer, he didn't want to play football, so the first few years we didn't really take much, you know, we watched it on TV, but we didn't really take much notice of it. But when we had the other two children, they both wanted to play footy, and from primary school level, and the middle one came home one day and said, "Dad, we haven't got a coach, you know, will you coach?" And I said, "Well, I've never played the game before, but I'll give it a go. I have played rugby union. I played rugby union at a pretty high standard in the UK, and it's pretty similar, especially when you're coaching kids, you know, the same thing, just, you know, basic skills." And Shane Harris, the SA umpires director, his child was in the side, and he said, "Look, I'll get you through your level one," and sent me off to Amy Stadium to do the level one, and it just went on from there. And as the boys got a bit older and wanted to play club football, we joined Golden Grove, and I'm one of those people that I can't just sit back and do nothing. I've got to be involved, and I started coaching my youngest one in his team in under nines, I think it was, and then within 2 years I was junior coordinator, and then a couple of years after that I became president. So I've been president now for about 13 years at Golden Grove. So we've come a long way in that time. Gone from, you know, basic grassroots in a place where we didn't have a clubhouse, we didn't even have anywhere to change. The boys got changed in the cars in the car park. With a lot of hard work and work with Teachery College Council, we've managed to get the facility we have at Harpers Field now, and believe it's as good as anything going around.
So just tell us a little bit how you fell in love with the game. You obviously said two of your kids played, but I find it interesting, coming from another sport, a lot of people that come from overseas, they see the AFL football and they have absolutely no idea what's going on. How was it for you, your transition into falling in love with it?
It was funny, because years ago, the exhibition match that they have in London, a few of my friends and I went down to London to see, I think it was Hawthorn and Carlton. The only reason I can remember it was because I remember the golden brown, horrible looking strip, and what's these? And these guys running around in tight shorts and belting the living daylights out of each other. And we were more interested in the goal umpires and the way they were, you know, they carried on with their little hats and waving their flags and that. That was my first introduction to footy, and when I came across here, and as I say, we watched a bit on TV, and it sort of came along with the Crows. I mean, the Crows had just started that time as well, so we sort of got on the bandwagon there with the Adelaide Football Club. And I think it was the pace of the game, just how quick the game was, and being from rugby, the physical side of it, and my wife loves it as well. She the same sort of thing. She just the pace of the game, the fact that it was going so quickly, and it just seemed a natural thing to do. I played rugby when I first came out here, but you know, it was after that it was pretty easy to transfer to footy, I think. So
And just moving back to the club now, you talked about the 5-year plan before. Were you the driving force in incorporating that?
Yeah, myself and the vice president, Dale Takano, we could see the club was becoming more than just a club. It was a business, and although it's run by volunteers, the amount of, you know, the barter takings, and, you know, the actual football side of it, it's become a small business. And to have a business like that, both of us coming from business backgrounds, we decided that we needed a strategic plan, and we needed a 5-year plan. So I set about writing a strategic plan, and Dale wrote the 5-year plan, and we joined them together with the A-grade coach and the rest of the committee, and come up with the plan that the club wanted to progress forward, both on and off the field. And football wise, we really want to be at the top. We felt an unrealistic thing we could go from 4 to 1 in 5 years, but we felt that 2 was achievable. After the first year, we we had the disappointment. We went out in straight sets in the finals, and you know, we felt that, you know, we let ourselves down a bit here. But last year, the boys really got into it, and you know, got a very narrow win against Eastern Park in a prelim final. You know, after being 10 goals down at half time, they came back to win it by about 5 points, I think, and that just buoyed them to go to a grand final and really turn it on. And you know, they had a fantastic day out, and you know, they got the club to where we wanted to be. I think, you know, realistically, to go to two straight away, you know, do we have the playing group? I think we do, but you know, is the club ready for it? That's another you know, challenge. You know, it's you know, it is a big jump. Every division you go up, it's you know, it's a 5-goal difference competition. And you know, what we've tried at the club over the last few years is to try and bring back all the. We've got 500 juniors play at our club, or 22 sides. And what we try to do is try to bring all these kids that have in the past that have gone through the development squads with the league clubs, and been encouraged to go to the T3 Gullies, you know, go to the Modbury's, where they're, you know, playing Division 1, Division 2 footy. We were down in 6, you know, I can understand that, you know, North and Centrals didn't want their kids playing, you know, that sort of level. But as we've gone up, we've managed to bring a lot of these boys back. And our current A grade is made up of, I think there's only 4 players in our current A grade squad who didn't play juniors at the club. So, and we've got guys now come up 150 games on top of 150 junior games, so it's a real family based club, you know. So it's going well.
Yeah, that's amazing how many players you've retained. So tell us a little bit about the player movement at your club in terms of recruits. Have you got any recruits in over the off season that have performed well for you, and did you lose anyone over the off season that hurt you a little bit?
No, we didn't lose anybody. There was a couple of players retired, but nobody really from the A grade that's retired. It was more B graders. But I mean, the big in for us was to get Matt Stenton and Brock Castry back. They've made a massive difference to the club. You know, they both played all their junior footy through Golden Grove, and you know, went out to Centrals, played league footy at Centrals, come back to us and still having a crack with the Adelaide Crows side, and enjoying their footy. Corey Pressler was, as I said before, he was a great in for us. Moved house up to our area. Kilburn boy through and through, but he's fitting the club really well, and he's one of the leaders of the club. And you know, he's hard on the field, and he keeps the boys their training, you know, going well. And he's been a massive in for us. But majority of the boys, as I say, have come through the junior structure, and you know, we're at the stage now where we've got under 18s coming through our B grade, which in a couple of years they're going to be stepping up the A grade footy as well. So, but, you know, the club's looking pretty good at the moment.
Okay, and just on the club, tell us a little bit about any sponsors you'd like to mention who supported the club in a big way.
I think, you know, this is the most important thing in a football club is your sponsorship, and it's been hard in the last few years, obviously, with the way the economy's gone and trying to get people to put cash in and you know, and reward them for what they put into the club. But we've got some very, very good sponsors. I mean, our major sponsor is the Golden Grove Village Shopping Centre. They're sort of what we would class as platinum sponsor. We get a lot of support from them, and they put a lot of the shops to us as well. So a lot of the local shops come, mainly vouchers for the juniors, but you know, it's it all helps, you know, to keep them going. But one sponsor particularly, a gold sponsor, and he's a real good friend of the club, and done a lot of work for us. It's Ray Lepka. His son plays A grade, but he owns a company called Weldmet down at Edwardstown. And his contribution to the club's been first class. He's brought other sponsors in. His brother-in-law Wayne Cloughton's come in as a gold sponsor. He's brought others in with him, and you know, we've got a very good working sponsorship committee who go out and really work actively with the local community. And you know, we encourage, having so many kids and so many parents there, we can encourage the parents to support the local businesses, which really, really helps. I mean, we've got JJ Stevenson along the road here, who they've just joined up, you know, heating and air conditioning company, and you know, it gets out around the club and the newsletters that, you know, and we encourage people to get the, I've just had my heating put in by them. So you know, it's a big thing. We're really, you know, we've really got to support our these people, because it, as I say, it's really, really hard to get sponsorship at the moment. So We are lucky. We've got a real good group, and it goes from supplying the meat on a Saturday, the bread, the pasties, the pies, you name it. Some don't give money, some is goods, which is just as good for us. But it just helps to keep the club moving forward.
Yeah, and also any club functions that you've had this year that have gone well, or any you've got upcoming?
Yeah, we had a good day on Saturday. Actually, we had a junior day. We encouraged all our juniors to come along, and we said if you wear your Golden Grove playing shirt, you get a pint of Coke. And we got a heap of kids come out, and we had some little games for them. They got prizes, and then they made a guard of honor for the A grade to go out on the ground. And fortunately, with them getting a win, they got all the boys, the kids in the change room afterwards, and made a circle around them, sang the song, and sprayed water on them, and the kids had a ball. So it was a real good. And then all the parents stayed back afterwards, and we do meals on a Saturday night. We just extended our clubhouse to put a professional kitchen in. So we had probably I would say about 40, 50 parents stayed back and had tea before they went home. So it was really good. We've got our major. It's annual ball, I would say, gala ball, dinner, coming up in July. If the boys have put a theme over James Bond, I don't know where that came from, but it's Sverre's on the park. Michael Sverre's, supports us really well, and so we're going there for a night away from the club, so the women can get all dressed up and the boys can have a good night away from the place. So we're trying to keep our functions not limited, but just have special ones. And we're conscious that people don't have a lot of money, and you kind of have something on every week, but you've got to raise funds. So we had a quiz night the other week, which raised about $7,000 for the club, and the guy who did it, Paul Hunter, did a fantastic job. Getting the questions, but because the clubhouse it doesn't hold more than, I think it's 154 fire regulations. Big functions, we have to move out of the club and hire somewhere else. So that's a bit of a downfall, but we get around it quite well. I mean, we get good deals from Teacher Gully Council to hire halls and that. So yeah, but it's going well.
Okay, thank you, Ian. I'm Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports, reporting for the SA Football Magazine. I've been joined by Division 3 Golden Grove President Ian Graham, and he's our feature president of the week.